Hi guys, so another Divi optimization hacks, and in this video I'm gonna show you the things that you need to avoid in order to improve your page speed in Divi. Okay, so Divi is really well known of how easy you can design your website or your modules, right? But the downside of that is every time you use the design tab on Divi, it will generate a new lines of code. So if your code or if that elements has a common style, it would be great that you create a global elements or a global styling. So that will be our tutorial today. So if you haven't done that yet, feel free to stay tuned because I'm gonna show you how it works. 1, 2, 3.
Best practices to make your website fast is to keep your code dry, which means do not repeat yourself. Now we know that, like in Divi Builder, it's been our kind of hobby to use the design tab options, like for this one, if we are styling the buttons. So like this one, if you style the buttons and click, like we are normally working on this stuff. Well, I'm not really against with that because it's really user friendly to those who are not comfortable working on a code. But if you check in here, so if we inspect the elements, the problem really happens here. So if we inspect the elements at the bottom, you'll see this part, right? So there is an HB heading, something like that. So I'm gonna copy that and let's put it on the notepad. Okay, then we have this ET underscore underscore button underscore zero. Okay, like if we inspect the elements again, I'm gonna show you this one because it has its three buttons in here. So there is an underscore buttons underscore zero for that. And now let's dive in for the other stuff here. So if I click that, another buttons, ET underscore PB underscore button one. And if we click this one, it has an ET underscore button underscore two. So basically what this means is we are declaring these styles, these similar styles, three times, and it's not really friendly in the back end side. So what I will do is I'm gonna grab all of these styles in here. Okay, so we will grab that, and I can probably come up with a color thing. Maybe let's come up with a burgundy button. Okay, BTN, and I'm gonna remove all of the important. Okay, yeah, I just want to remove the important thing there. Okay, and there is something like an hover in here, like a hover, this arrow button hover. So what we can do there is click this hover stuff and check this hover to see the styling. So this is the, I believe this is the hover. No, we should come up to the after part. So for the after part, so this is the family buttons import, so this arrow thing there, so we will just get everything. I'm gonna copy that again. We will copy that part. Actually, I love to use the, so there is like this part. I'm gonna remove everything there. Just keep it like that. I should be using the Visual Studio Code, but yeah, let's just keep that as is. And let's change it to burgundy. Okay, change everything to burgundy. Everything, the commented version. So we remove that. And I will put this on the theme options, okay? And let's have a code in here, global buttons. with that. So we can, I can also come up with a lighter version or light BTN classes if that will be the case. So I have already a burgundy thing. Now it's time to reset all of the buttons and just use the CSS class. Okay, so I'm gonna enable the visual builder and we will place this ETN burgundy button in here. By the way guys, I really recommend that you check my article version because in case I miss some information in this tutorial, because I normally put all my information in my article version. It's more, it has more information versus on the video thing, but I still want you to check the video so you really can understand the process. Okay, so I'm gonna reset this button in here. So let's click that reset. This is how it looks in the reset area, and let's add the class. So we have that. Okay, so we have that class, and let's come up with a styling in here. Save that buttons. So there's still some codes, like it's still not really right. Okay, so we have that thing already. So we fixed that thing. Now what I'm just trying to say in here guys is I just want to keep everything dry. So if there is a common styling with your buttons, with your text, and with your blurbs, then instead of using the design tab, I recommend that you declare a CSS class into your modules. That will make your codes cleaner on the back end. Like it looks, it is simple. It is simple on the front end side. It's easy to design on that, but it's not really friendly in terms of the back end, in terms of the painting, in terms of the Google speed for the lighthouse performance. So I believe it will save you some decent amount of data if you do that in all of your modules. So, but if your modules like this one has a common, you know, common styling. So instead of using the design tab, what you can just set a class, a CSS class, and declare the styling into your styles.css, and then make it and then use the CSS class name in here. So that really, like, this the gist of it, like that's what I'm trying to say on you guys. So yeah, it is more into optimization of your website. So if that is something you are concerned of, then that is something that you should consider. Okay, I know it's kind of pain on the ass on your part because the design tab is obviously super friendly to use, but there is a downside. I hope guys that makes sense.